Today we're going to cover servicing an HVAC unit, which looks like this. It's kind of noisy, so I might have to record audio later to explain, but I'll try to show you what I'm doing.
So this is a LENNOX HVAC, controls heating and air condition. Basically, you should maintain it every 3 months. One of the things you have to do is change the filters. In this particular model, it has a slider, so you can slide the filters out. You should make a note of the size, so you buy the appropriate size and date it, so you can know when last the filters were changed. On this side, there are different panels to reset and so forth. Sometimes you have to clean the vents too. I'm not going to clean the vents in this video, but I'm just going to show you something else, because sometimes you may have to reset it, especially like if electricity goes off or there's a power surge or something. Sometimes you might have to go in the back and open these doors. Now, these are the large LENNOX units. They are smaller ones. But these models, they control the very large buildings. On the left, to show you what the different error messages are. You have your cooling systems, you have your motherboards and stuff, which is CPU controlling it. And you see that button there? That resets the system. Sometimes right next to it, those LED lights, they give a code if something is wrong. And sometimes you have to hit that button to reset it. Sometimes if that doesn't work, the other thing you can do is go to the electrical panel and turn off electricity to the unit and wait a couple minutes and then turn it back on. That's another way to reset the system, so the system can reboot just like you would a normal computer. And once you do that, you come back then, you check the panel. Another thing you could do is you could press that red button, which resets everything. But I should warn you that whenever you're inside of here, there's a lot of electrical components. You have to be careful of what you're doing. But those codes that are there, you can read the panel on the left and it will tell you what the error code means. So that if you have to call guys out, they will know what to do when they come to service and repair. Just be careful whatever you do.